For those in the market for flavor, there's Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, a flavorful drink that's a modern twist on a Mexican street classic. With four vibrant and refreshing flavors, pineapple, watermelon, hibiscus, and cucumber lime, made with a splash of real fruit juice. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas are perfect for any fiesta, small or big. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, boldly authentic, vibrantly flavorful. Drink responsibly. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas flavored beers imported by Crown Imports, Chicago, Illinois. Hibiscus contains juice only for color.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Without the ones like you who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
All right, places, please. The Daly Migs Show is on deck. Guitars plugged in. Drums ready to go. Chickens.
They're a-clucking.
Other animals. And action.
This is the Daly Migs Show on The Rock with Taryn Daly and Steve Migs.
While listening to the Daly Migs Show, please refrain from any unnecessary finger gesturing.
99.9 KISW.
Good morning, Steve Migs, Danny and Sarah.
Taryn Daly.
I was not necessarily expecting a confetti cannon today, but maybe some balloons.
Is it your birthday?
No.
Your anniversary.
Yes, my 11-year anniversary.
Of being married?
Of KISW greatness.
Oh, my bad. All right. There you go.
I don't know that there's a traditional way to celebrate an 11th anniversary.
Well, you're employed, so congratulations.
Yes.
Every day is a celebration when you're still employed in the world of radio.
This is true.
Yes.
I do have an idea, though, of how I would like to celebrate.
How?
Can we fly our freak flags today?
Woo! You know it. Well, you already are with that t-shirt that you're wearing.
Oh, this
Have you seen Taryn Daly's t-shirt?
Yeah, I saw it.
It was from Ryan Castle. Maybe for my 11th anniversary. It says, Chickens, the pet that poops breakfast. Now let's inform the Rockaholics.
Knowledge is power. So give us five-ish minutes and we'll give you, some interesting stuff you can talk about at work. This is the Daly Migs Download.
A.K.A. the DMD.
Here's your daily dose of doings happening in the world.
And DMD is brought to you by Palace Law. And today is a day for you to wear bell bottoms. If anyone... Oh my gosh, you are. I was about to say, if anybody on this show would be wearing bell bottoms, I'd imagine it would be Taryn Daly. And today is bell bottoms day.
I didn't even know that. It was a complete coincidence.
Well, where's our deep dish pizza then? Because it's also deep dish pizza day.
I wish I would have known.
Much would have rather that. And here's a good question for you guys. You might have to pull out your phones and check your Apple Maps or whatever map app that you have on your phone. Today is National Walk to Work Day. So how long do you think it would take for you to walk to work? I feel like Taryn Daly would have the longest walk.
It's going to be like... Oh, my gosh. 19 hours.
19 hours.
19 hours.
You better get walking.
A little jaunt.
Yeah, mine is 16 hours and 30 minutes.
Wow.
All right, so between Danny and Sarah, I'm trying to think of who would have the longer walk.
I'm guessing
Danny. Yeah.
2 hours and 45 minutes.
That's it?
Yep.
That's easy.
Yeah.
That could be a day just going home to Puyallup around 3 in the afternoon after a Mariners game in a car.
Yeah.
I beat you barely, Danny. 2 hours and 33 minutes to get to Mercer Island.
So needless to say, none of us are walking to work.
Not going
to
happen.
And today, I can't believe this. It was 30 years ago today. Today's the 30th anniversary of Kurt Cobain's passing.
That's wild.
1994.
The 90s were only 10 years ago. What are you talking about?
It still
Steve?
Feels
no
that way.
Way.
And so we're talking about walking to work. And Sarah, who lives in Mercer Island, have you been impacted by the landslides that are going on right now there?
No, but my mother-in-law was telling me about this yesterday.
It's freaky. I saw this yesterday. It's a leaking underground water pipe in Mercer Island. It's caused the evacuation of approximately 20 homes due to the risk of landslides and dangerous flooding. So you're good. You're staying in your place.
I hope so, yeah. I haven't evacuated yet.
Well, they would. Well, maybe your dad's going to try and make that happen.
Wow.
That's how he gets you out of the house.
No.
Landslides, get out! And then he just sits on the couch, watches TV. Apparently, they're putting a bunch of people over at the event center as a gathering space and providing online and information via social media as well.
Wow.
Yeah, real crazy.
Also crazy, a 13-year-old in West Vancouver, BC is facing charges after crashing a Lamborghini. He was driving without the owner's knowledge, apparently, and there are multiple different reports.
Like, what kind of parents give their kid a Lamborghini?
There's a couple different sides to the story. Nobody really knows what exactly went down. Some people say it was the parents' Lamborghini. Other people are saying that he somehow got a dealership to let him do a test drive. So no one really knows exactly what happened yet. But he and his friend went for a little joyride. The damage is very severe. The car is a complete loss.
I don't even want to look at a Lamborghini.
No.
Touch a Lamborghini in fear that I might dent it, scratch it, or anything. I got to go back to the part where you said that he might have gotten it from a dealership. Do we have pictures of this 13-year-old? Like, how old does he look?
Does he have a mustache?
He must.
I don't know.
Or
it's
was he
so
sitting
wild
on the shoulders of his friend with a big trench coat?
Even hypothetically, if you thought he was 16 and legally able to drive, why would you let a 16-year-old take a Lamborghini for a test drive?
If that's true, I mean, that's their fault. Because I remember when I had a car, you got to give them your driver's license.
Yes.
You got to fill out a bunch of information, maybe even give them your insurance information as well. Who just hands off a Lamborghini? That sounds kind of suspect.
Absolutely.
Oh, man, this weekend, big weekend for us wrestling fans. It's WrestleMania weekend, the showcase of immortals. Sorry, I got a little
mean? What does that mean?
I don't even know, but they say that a lot. So it's a showcase of immortal people, clearly.
Okay.
Duh, you dummy. I don't know what it means either, but 2 days starting off tomorrow, and then the next day, Cody Rhodes finally finish his story by beating Roman Reigns for the WWE Championship. We will find out this weekend.
Who do you root for?
Oh, I'm a Cody Rhodes guy.
Okay.
All the way. Yes, I love Cody Rhodes. But one wrestling star had a little bit of a weird situation that happened just a couple of days ago. Her name's Chelsea Green, actually originally from the Vancouver, British Columbia area, but she's now part of the WWE, just crushing it there. She's very attractive. And somehow this swanky New York City hotel bar that she was at with one of her other friends told her that her and her friend need to leave. They're like, why do we need to leave? And they said, well, it's clear that you two are escorts. They thought because of what she was wearing. And I saw the picture. She's just wearing like a short-ish, not even like super short, but it doesn't even matter. But she's wearing a skirt, some boots, and just like a tight white top, but it's nothing crazy.
I saw the photo. It's a very normal outfit.
Yeah,
it does not
like,
scream escort to
me.
Yeah,
she's like, I'm not a hooker. And they're like, no, yes, you are. And they told her to get out of the bar. And of course, she put it up on social media. She's not too happy about it. I do love her husband, who used to be in the WWE. He was known as Zack Ryder. He's Matt Cardona. He shared this story, and he's just like, look at my whore wife, or something like that. He's just having fun with it. Like, I love my escort wife, which I think was pretty damn funny. Hey, this weekend, of course, it's a big weekend for you college basketball fans. It's the NCAA men's tournament. It's going to be happening to women's as well. We're crowning a national championship. What does it happen? The Final Four, you've got number 11 NC State taking on number 1 Purdue. Number 4 Alabama taking on number 1 UConn as well. So it's going to be a fun weekend tomorrow.
That's Sarah's team.
Yeah.
That's right.
From Kentucky.
That's right. We're going to have to figure out whether or not we're all chugging milk by next week.
Oh, God. I'm sure not.
I don't know. The way that Danny's calculating these points, you just don't know. You might win it all and still lose with the way he's doing math.
Yeah. That's true.
Hey, we're going to hit a high of 53 degrees. It's going to be cloudy today, and that is the DMD, and that's what's up.
What do bathtubs, hockey, and Chinese food have in common? We're going to tell you at 620.
The Daily Mix Show.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance, too, with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done.
At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
For those in the market for flavor, there's Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, a flavorful drink that's a modern twist on a Mexican street classic with four vibrant and refreshing flavors. Pineapple, watermelon, hibiscus, and cucumber lime, made with a splash of real fruit juice. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas are perfect for any fiesta, small or big. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, boldly authentic, vibrantly flavorful. Drink responsibly. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas flavored beers imported by Crown Imports, Chicago, Illinois. Hibiscus contains juice only for color.
They say a picture is worth a thousand words. Especially these. Each picture captures a moment in time in the crazy lives of the Daily Mix show. Here's four shots to wake you up.
Rockaholics, we cordially invite you to give us a follow on social media. Our handle is at Daily Migs. We posted a picture that has four shots, four yes. photos that sum up the days that we had yesterday.
Now, why are you in a bathtub?
Well, as you maybe have
heard, besides being clean, but you're wearing clothes.
I'm wearing clothes in a bathtub. The bathtub doesn't even have water yet because...
Doesn't even have walls, apparently.
No. So we are doing an addition on our house. Because our house is weird, and so we're trying to make an improvement. And we're adding a bathroom, and this bathroom is going to have a bathtub.
Do you not have a bathtub right now?
We don't have a bathtub.
We've
never had a tub.
Oh, Taryn's a baller all
you
of a
guys,
sudden.
I'm so excited. I'm going to have a good soak in there.
Brad's almost my height. He's over 6 foot, right?
Oh, yeah. He's like 6'1".
Okay. I mean, I love bathtubs, but I could barely fit in one. Can he fit in this one?
I mean... He will have to try.
He'll make it work. He's spending all this money. You're taking a bath, Brad.
But I'm also excited for Barrett because, you know, kids love a bath. And he doesn't get to do that because we just have showers in our house.
Tatum's funny. She hates taking a bath until she's in the bath. And then she never wants to get out of it.
Oh, yeah.
Cries, screams, I don't want to take a bath. And all of a sudden you put her in the bath. And she's like, this is so much fun. I'm swimming. And then you're like, okay, it's time to get out of the bath. I don't want to take... I'm like, dude, we do this every freaking day. At what point is there going to be a switch that turns in your head that says, hey, baths are fun.
Baths are awesome. And they delivered our bathtub this week. And I was like, this seems so weird that it's here already. But I wasn't thinking. They have to put it in the window before the window gets installed because it's so large.
This is crazy.
I know. I didn't even know that.
You're like living a reality home improvement show right now.
Could also be a nightmare.
I was going to say, it's also not 30 minutes, though. Yours is a lifetime.
So the tub is in, and soon, very soon, hopefully, we'll be able to actually use it.
So then we go from a bathtub to Chinese food.
Yeah.
Why do you look so happy?
Because that's like the best dish is being served to me.
It does look delicious.
Yes, it's a tofu and a bunch of veggies. You could eat it too. It's vegan.
Nice.
My anniversary was a few weeks ago, my 1 year, and my in-laws decided to take us out to dinner. So it was a belated year celebration. We were going to do it the weekend before, but their dog wasn't doing too great.
Oh.
So, yeah. So literally the day of our anniversary, kind of morbid, but it was either like we were going to go out to dinner or there might have been a chance that George and I would have to go.
Put the dog down?
Yes.
Oh my God.
I know. Luckily.
An awful decision to make.
George is like, babe, we might do our anniversary dinner date or... We might have to say goodbye to Little Mercy. But
I think picking a dish at a Chinese food place is a little bit easier to pick than making that decision.
Yeah, so Mercy's doing great now, and we finally got to have our dinner with the in-laws.
And I'm just curious, what is that dish called?
Oh, it's called Hunan Tofu.
Mm.
It's just a bunch of tofu and a bunch of vegetables. And then we also got crispy eggplant, which is phenomenal. Uptown China in Queen Anne. So good.
Oh, I've been there.
Yeah.
Yeah, that place is awesome.
It's right next to the Climate Pledge, and, you know, it's like a perfect little spot right before a game.
I feel like that place has been around forever, too.
Forever. Oh, yeah. They know George and his family since George was like a wee one.
Oh, my gosh.
So they love us. They treat us like royalty there.
It's like my family. We go to Chinese food places, and all the employees know our family as well. But they knew him because my dad would always argue with them about the amount of like little like crunchy noodles that you would get on the appetizer plate.
He wanted more?
Yes, he would fight with them.
Oh, no.
He would yell at them if they didn't give him enough. They didn't give him enough sauces, didn't give him enough napkins. It was a thing. It was very embarrassing.
That sounds embarrassing.
So they knew us for different reasons.
Yes.
Danny, what the hell is in your picture?
Oh, it's my new friend. His name is Steve.
Named after this Steve?
Named after that Steve.
You got crabs?
I did.
Wow. That's an HR situation I don't want to talk about on the air.
No, I go down to Alki, and yesterday just needed a little mental break, and I just go down by the water and the rocky beach, and I like to find little crabs under the rocks. And I found this little guy, and I was having my little walking stick with me, and he grabbed on, and I was like, oh, what's up, Steve? I don't know, he just looked like Steve to me, so I named him Steve.
Crab legs!
Did you eat him?
I know I did not eat him.
I like that he looks like he wanted to just go home with you.
Yeah, he was like holding my little stick.
Can you have a pet crab?
I mean, people keep hermit crabs.
Why don't you bring him home? Get like a little tank.
I probably should. Well, we have a tank already, but I don't know if he would have done well in our fish tank.
In your freshwater fish tank.
Yeah. Or maybe the fish would do well with Steve in your fish tank.
Either one, yeah.
Crab legs!
Can we save the best for last today?
My picture.
Yes.
Of young Steve rocking roller hockey goalie equipment on a Christmas celebration.
Can I also just like toot your horn a little bit? You just don't age. You look so much like that now. What is your skincare routine?
Clearly, Taryn's bad vision is my skincare routine. What the hell are you talking about? I don't have the mullet anymore. Did you see the sweet mullet?
Oh, my God. Okay, so if you really look, you can see the mullet.
Yeah, you can see it kind of in the background. In the wind, also, that fancy-looking TV that's right behind it as well, which is pretty sweet. Like, that's total, like, 80s-era television entertainment center.
It's ultimate Flashback Friday action.
So I put this up just because I went down, like, a little nostalgia road yesterday after yesterday's show. So we had this kid on yesterday morning. His name is Quinn. He's 12 years old. And we met him at the Mariners game. And if you missed it, when we were at the Mariners game, him and his family came up to us and they're like, we're big fans of the show. We love that segment, Hook or Shook, which we do every morning at 9:20. And it's basically like a name that tune kind of a game show thing where we play the hook of a song for 1 second and then the listener has to guess the name of the band and the name of the song. And apparently Quinn, who's 12, is always crushing it at home. So he wanted to play. So we put him to the test at the Mariners game and Danny just pulled out a song off of his phone and we had him play right there at the Mariners game and it sounded like this.
So you are a big fan of the Hook or Shook segment?
Yeah.
12 years old, you think you can name a song in 1 second?
Maybe, probably.
I have faith. Right. I really do.
All right, we're going to give it a whirl. Danny's got a song that's going to play off of his phone. Ready?
Can I get it again?
Yeah. All right.
Yeah, all right. That's Wood by Alice in Chains.
Oh, Quinn, 12 years old. No stopping him.
That's easy. That's an easy one.
So, call in sometime. He called in yesterday. He played Hook or Shook, nailed it without even having to hear it again. It was a Tool song. And was it Schism?
Yes.
And he just crushed it in 1 second. And just we find out that he's just obsessed with music, which is so cool. He plays the bass and all that cool stuff. So, someone texted in saying, hearing Quinn was awesome. Makes me think about being 12 and being obsessive fan of heavy metal music. I knew everything. What about you guys? What was something that you knew everything about as a kid? And that's what made me go down that little rabbit hole of like, what was I obsessed with? And it was hockey and baseball, but more hockey. I was so obsessed with hockey that I knew every number of every player on the teams, like the Devils, not just my team, but any team. I also knew the numbers of every player that played for like the minor league team. I was like Rain Man when it came to like what I knew about hockey. And it's just crazy to think as a kid, I was able to retain all that information. Now, I can't remember who's doing what and what they're playing, like what number they are in the Kraken. It's just like, what the hell?
I still think of you as a massive hockey fan, but not even in the same vein as 12-year-old Steve.
Oh, dude, 12-year-old Steve was insane.
That is awesome.
Like, I mean, I could just rattle off like what the lines were for each team and who was playing this, what goalie was playing. It was just like one of those things where I was just massively obsessed. And I thought that text was really fun and what a fun topic to have about like what you were obsessed with. I mean, yeah, as an adult, I'm sure there's things we're all obsessed with. But when we're a teen, that's when we're really obsessed about something. Like Quinn.
So based on Quinn's obsessive knowledge of music that was very impressive to all, and I guess Steve's knowledge of hockey at age 12, when you were a teen or even as an adult, what did you obsess over? What was that one thing that you knew inside and out? Call us up now, 206-803-ROCK. Your calls after Pearl Jam.
The Daily Migs Show.
When you were a teen or even as an adult, what did you obsess over? What is that one thing that you knew inside and out, Rockaholics? 206-803-ROCK.
A few people did text in with some of the stuff that they obsessed over, including Nate. Nate said, I was obsessed with the Spice Girls. Yeah. I could sing every song front to back, not just the hits. I saw Spice World at least 50 times. I would watch it every week when I was a teenager. Yes, I was 12.
La, 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 la,
Call to the world.
Pass off your life.
Every boy, every girl.
Pass off your life.
People of the world.
Pass off your life.
That's why I'm sick of you.
I'm with you, Barrett. Your mom is weird.
Spice World was a whole vibe, dude.
Dude, me and my old bandmates, we went and saw Spice World.
Did you really?
Yeah. We were covering a Spice Girls song. We were covering Wannabe. And we did like a Pixies version of it, which I still to this day wish we would have went to the studio and recorded, because it would always tear the house down. Whenever we would play it, which we didn't do a lot, but whenever we would cover it in front of a crowd, it would take like about 45 seconds to a minute for people to register what we were doing. And then it was just like, this is amazing. Bunch of like, you know, nerdy, hipster, indie rock kids all freaking out over Zigga Zigga. Another person just texted in saying at 206-803-ROCK, obsessive Metallica fan. I was 13 when I first heard Saint Anger.
Oh.
And then my dad said, if you like this, you'll love their earlier stuff. He was right. That's a good dad. He's probably like, this is not the best Metallica.
This is not peak Metallica. Right. We got to start at the beginning and work our way up.
I think it's adorable that you like this record. You're one of the few. But let's go back and listen to some of their really good stuff.
206-803-ROCK. When you were a teen, what was that one thing you knew inside and out?
Have you ever heard the time that I called into a sports radio station when I was a teenager, maybe 13, maybe 14 years old? Like, this goes back. This is what really got me thinking about Quinn calling in and just being an obsessive music fan. And that was a lot of fun talking to him yesterday morning. Have you ever heard the time that I called into a radio station?
No. What prompted this?
I was just a nerdy kid that loved calling into radio. So my buddies, we all thought it would be awesome if we could get on the radio. But we were like 12, 13, 14 years old. So we would all stay up late at night, not together, but in our own homes. And it would like, we would geek out if we heard one of our other buddies on the overnight sports radio show.
That is very cute.
Which is WFAN. It's a massive radio station in New York and all that kind of stuff. Their overnight guy was Steve Summers. Schmoozing under the covers with Steve Summers.
Schmoozing under the covers.
Something like that. I could be wrong. Maybe I'm saying it wrong. But anyways, we were literally under the covers. Like, I was like trying to hide from my parents so they didn't hear me. So I put the covers over my head, even though I'm in my own bedroom. But I have to sneak into their bedroom, take their cordless phone.
Sneak it
back into my bedroom, and then spend all night not going to bed, not sleeping, but trying to get through to this overnight sports radio talk show.
Did you have a plan for what you would do when you got through?
Yeah, talk about the Devils.
Okay, because this is Hockey Steve.
This is obsessed hockey fan Steve. It didn't matter if it was football season, baseball season, to the point where they started getting really annoyed with me, which I understand.
So they knew you?
Oh, yeah. He would eventually just hang up on me. I have audio of one of the times that I called in. And it'll show you just how obsessed I was. Like, I was already telling him, like, you know Martin Brodeur, one of the greatest goalies of all time. He still hadn't played in the NHL yet. And I'm like, they need to bring him up. He's the future of the team. I didn't sound nearly as cool saying it. Like, I definitely didn't sound nearly as cool as Quinn. Are you ready to hear this?
I'm ready.
All right.
Steve is calling from Brooklyn.
How you doing, Steve?
Morning, Steve.
I want to talk about when you talked to an earlier about a caller with Schoenberg and the Devils.
Uh-huh.
He's already like, okay. What the hell am I doing? I got to get out of the overnights.
This is so cute.
Stupid, nervous teenagers are calling me all the time.
And you said that the best thing they should do is probably get a goalie?
Yeah, another goaltender for behind Terreri, one who can play.
I guess the best thing they could do is bring up Brodeur and try to work him in a couple of games.
And it would be worth bringing him up?
I think so. I mean, he proved that he could play. Like in the NHL caliber level.
Steve, thanks for calling.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Okay.
I don't know what I'm thinking, but I'm picturing him looking at his producer or his phone screen going, what are you doing to me? What are you doing to me? Giving me these nervous 14-year-olds to call. And we would do this all the time.
Oh, my. That kind of sounded like the same voice when you nervously interviewed Smashing Pumpkins. Hey, guys. I just really think you're so special, and I really like that album you released, Siamese.
I want to talk about when you talked to an earlier about a caller with Schoenberg and the Devils.
He's like, spit it out, Steve. Let's go.
You are so precious, though. You've always had radio in your blood.
Yeah, but I hear Quinn. Quinn's all confident. He's just like, I'm like, he's 12. And he's just like, yeah. Allison Chains.
Easy. What's next?
Right. And I'm like,
the thing about the New Jersey Devils, Martin Brodeur.
You need to throw your accent on that, too.
Yeah. I did love the accent. The you accent could totally is my hear favorite it. Part.
The strong accent.
Oh, that was beautiful. Thanks for that.
Did you ever call radio stations when you were a kid?
Hell yes. I used to call our coworker, Eric Powers, back in the day.
I wish you had audio on
that.
Oh,
my God. I would die. I used to call Eric Powers all the time.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
What were you calling him for?
Just probably to request boys to men. Honestly. Rockaholics. How would you like to beat Steve? He is currently 83, 23, and 12 in 2024. 206-803-ROCK. We'll play Beat Migs at 6:50.
The Daily Migs Show.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
You've probably heard about generative artificial intelligence, but are you vigilant to its exploitability? Generative AI is shaping society and transforming our daily lives. While we want to embrace the potential, we must also set the standards for responsible use and safeguard the future of our digital world. HackerOne employs over 2 million plus ethical hackers, 750 of them specializing in prompt hacking and other AI security and testing. The creative approach taken by a diverse pool of ethical hackers is the best way to discover vulnerabilities. When launching new AI deployments, let HackerOne's AI red teaming address the novel challenges of AI safety and security for your business. AI innovation can only be effective if models are tested for safety and security issues that could cause harm. Make sure your AI models and deployments can't be tricked into providing information beyond their intended use, and that security flaws can't be exploited to access confidential data or systems with HackerOne. Learn more about our AI red teaming today at hackerone.com/AI.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Without the ones like you who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
For those in the market for flavor, there's Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, a flavorful drink that's a modern twist on a Mexican street classic with four vibrant and refreshing flavors. Pineapple, watermelon, hibiscus, and cucumber lime, made with a splash of real fruit juice. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas are perfect for any fiesta, small or big. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, boldly authentic, vibrantly flavorful. Drink responsibly. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas flavored beers imported by Crown Imports, Chicago, Illinois. Hibiscus contains juice only for color.
The Daily Migs Show presents the most popular radio game on this side of the speaker. Let's play Beat Migs.
Beat Migs, don't be a loser.
Migs. I know I sure am, because we made it. It's Friday. There they go.
No, I can't do it.
Wow.
Yes.
Taryn's ready to, like, mosh.
have not had a good mosh session in a long time. The older I get, the least likely I am to do it.
The older I get, the more moshing hurts.
Oh, yeah.
Especially that next day. The last time I moshed was a Biohazard concert, and I was literally sore for 2 weeks after that concert. I was like, I'm good.
I think the last time I moshed was a Bad Religion show up in Vancouver, and it was Brad that basically told me, this is your last mosh. I hope you enjoy it. he did not enjoy watching me mosh.
It was a good run, but it's over.
It's over.
I just did a few headbangs at one of the emo nights that Danny DJed, and my neck was sore for 3 days.
That's a bangover.
It was a bangover for sure. Gosh. Let's get to Russ from Olympia. Russ, are you there?
I am. Good morning.
Good morning. I'm Sarah, your host, and it's time for you to get out of here, Steve.
Bye-bye.
For those playing at home, Russ has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you will only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Let's do it.
How many points does the Star of David have?
5.
No.
4.
No.
6.
Yes. Hell's Bells is the song off what AC/DC album?
Pass.
NCAA men's basketball is down to the final 4. NC State, Purdue, Alabama, and what other team?
UConn.
Yes. Who is the main antagonist in the first Avengers movie?
Loki.
Yes. The iconic Gateway Arch is located in what U.S. state?
Missouri.
Yes. What sitcom did Zooey Deschanel star in as Jess Day?
New Girl.
Correct. What zodiac sign is half man, half horse?
Pisces?
No.
Ash.
What year did Facebook change its name to Meta?
2021?
Yes. Doja Cat has the hit song titled Paint the Town What Color?
Can you say it again?
Doja Cat has the hit song titled Paint the Town What Color?
Red.
Yay,
baby.
I'm impressed you got that one. That gives you 7 correct, Russ.
I'm just going to say it right now. In Russ, we trust.
Oh. Well, wow.
I'm banking on it.
Yes.
There's some in there I don't think Steve's going to know.
Uh-oh.
You feel it?
I'm feeling it.
Feel the Russ?
Feeling the Russ.
Steve. Whoa. Are you ready?
Mr. Unlimited.
In Russ, we trust.
Yeah.
How many points does the Star of David have?
What Star of David? Oh, man. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Correct. Hell's Bells is a song off what AC/DC album?
That Back in Black?
It is. NCAA men's basketball is down to the final 4. NC State, Purdue, Alabama, and what other team?
Your favorite, UConn.
You know it. Who is the main antagonist in the first Avengers movie?
Ooh, is that Magneto?
No.
Dr. Octopus?
No.
Lindsay Lohan?
No. The iconic Gateway Arch is located in what U.S. state?
Missouri.
Yes. What sitcom did Zooey Deschanel star in as Jess Day?
That's Jess. New Girl.
Yes. What zodiac sign is half man, half horse?
Taurus.
No.
Horus.
No.
No. Sagittarius.
Yes. What year did Facebook change its name to Meta?
2020?
No.
2021.
Correct. Doja Cat has the hit song titled Paint the Town What Color?
Pink.
No.
Red?
Yes. Woo, let's see.
Oh, it's like saying, paint the town red, isn't it?
Yeah.
And you know that song. Let's get real.
No,
and
I don't, actually.
And with that, you get 8 correct, which is a win. 8-7.
Yes.
You should have not had trust in Russ, Taryn.
I'm sorry, Russ. We can always try another time.
Good game, Steve.
Thank you, my friend.
Oh, yes. Another one bites the dust.
Yeah, you did pretty good.
Pretty good.
Give it to you.
Did great.
The main antagonist in the first Avengers movie, though, is Loki.
Loki,
and
that's
Russ
right.
Russ knew that.
Yep, but it did not matter.
I have a quick question. Show of hands, who's been up in the Gateway Arch?
Nope. Never.
Oh, no. I don't even know if I've ever been to Missouri.
Really?
No, I haven't.
I don't think I have either.
It is the most claustrophobic I've ever been in my life.
Oh, so you've been...
up in the arch.
At the top?
Yes.
How small is it?
They put you in this little tiny egg, and it takes you up. It's like a little egg shaped thing. I mean, maybe
like an elevator.
Yes.
And the elevator sounds like.
And it is small. And especially if you go in the summertime, even if there is any sort of air conditioning, when you get there,
it's just too much.
It's warm and stressful.
So how many people are in there at any given time?
I can't remember. It might be like four.
That's
five,
it.
Five, six, something like that. It's not very large.
Honestly, I did not know until right now that you could actually go in the arch.
Me either.
I just thought it was like a visual thing. Like you just show up, you look at it, like, there's an arch. Okay, cool. Let's move on with our lives.
You can go up, but I just don't recommend it if you're claustrophobic.
I did know about it only because of the movie Vacation. When they're driving, they're like, hey, look, kids, it's a great, the archway to the west. And the kid asks, can we go up in it, Dad? And he's like, no.
Oh, yeah. Dude, I don't even remember that scene from the movie, to be honest
with
you.
So small, but that's
so funny.
Yeah.
Well, it has been a couple of weeks since we last had an airplane passenger meltdown. But don't worry. Another one just happened, and it might be the best one yet. You're going to hear all about it after Nirvana.
The Daily Migs Show.
There was another airline passenger meltdown this week. And it happened on Spirit. I'm starting to think they need to put one of those countdowns up.
Yes.
0 days since our last meltdown.
It's been 17 days since we had someone lose their mind.
So, of course, someone who was on the plane posted this woman who was completely freaking out while three deputies were trying to take her off of the flight for being disruptive. And here is the audio.
Oh, crap. I thought I had it. There it is. Here we go.
I'll be walked out on my own. You don't need to. Why are you doing that? Why are you acting like I'm
there's nothing better than saying something weird and having everyone on the plane laugh at you out. Like a rascal?
A rascal is what I heard.
Let this go. Can I do that with freedom? All I care about is freedom. That's fine. I've been there before.
Okay.
That's fine.
I wish that the flight thing could be like, all right, real quick, calm down for a second. Why were you there before? We need to know. We need to understand what's going on with you where you're cool with being arrested.
This nigga's hurting my elbow. He's hurting my wrist. You're hurting me, Sheriff.
Does Barrett ever do that where he pretends that he's hurt and he makes like the most ridiculous sounds? Because I know Tatum does that. And it's clear you're not hurt. You're making these sounds up.
And then 5 seconds later, everything is fine.
Right.
I can't breathe. This is George Floyd.
Get off the plane.
I can't breathe.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we will need everyone to.
Ladies and gentlemen, I can't breathe.
Deplane the aircraft.
Now they're all pissed off. Did she just say, ladies and gentlemen, I can't breathe?
She also apparently saw that people had their phones out and they encouraged everyone else to go ahead and record. And everybody already was doing
it. You don't need to ask people to record. Of course, everybody's pulling out their phone whenever there's a meltdown.
She also told one of the hecklers to shut up and compared him to a well-known actor.
Hey, record!
We see you hit him.
Yeah, that's assault. Yeah, just assaulted an officer.
Shut up, Richard Gere.
So, yeah, we're back in airplane chaos business, Rockaholics.
Are you complimented if someone just said, hey, shut up, Richard Gere? I'm like, you know what? Richard Gere's a good-looking guy. Could have been worse.
Richard Gere's very handsome.
I know if it was me, she'd be like, shut up, Shrek.
Today marks the 30th anniversary of a death that not only rocked the whole world, but especially here in the Pacific Northwest. We will talk about it at 7:20.
The Daily Migs Show.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
For those in the market for flavor, there's Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, a flavorful drink that's a modern twist on a Mexican street classic with four vibrant and refreshing flavors. pineapple, watermelon, hibiscus, and cucumber lime, made with a splash of real fruit juice. Modelo spiked aguas frescas are perfect for any fiesta, small or big. Modelo spiked aguas frescas, boldly authentic, vibrantly flavorful. Drink responsibly. Modelo spiked aguas frescas flavored beers imported by Crown Imports, Chicago, Illinois. Hibiscus contains juice only for color.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Today is the 30th anniversary of the passing of Kurt Cobain. And it's hard to believe that you just blink and 30 years have gone by.
I know, when we were talking about it before the show started, we're like, okay, today is the anniversary of Kurt. We definitely want to show some love and talk about it. And I was like, I didn't really do the math until I looked at 1994. And I was like, holy smokes, 30 years ago?
Many people probably recall learning about this from Kurt Loder of MTV News.
Hi, I'm Kurt Loder with an MTV News special report on a very sad day. Kurt Cobain, the leader of one of rock's most gifted and promising bands, Nirvana, is dead, and this is the story as we know it so far. Cobain's body was found in a house in Seattle on Friday morning. He was dead of an apparently self-inflicted shotgun blast to the head. Police found what is said to be a suicide note at the scene, but have not yet divulged its contents. Cobain, who was 27, had reportedly been missing for about 6 days, according to his mother.
I remember being in college when all of this happened, which obviously dates me a little bit, but I remember being in college and we had shared suites that had cable. We didn't have cable in our rooms, but so like MTV was on all the time. Like MTV was just what we all watched. Mm-hmm. And I remember when that happened and all of a sudden, like, I was at the college radio station, which we also had the TVs, and thinking, I gotta get on the air and we gotta mention this. You know, we gotta stop everything that we're doing. But I remember just running to the station and seeing people that I knew, and everyone just kind of had like this blank look on their face because everybody found out rather quickly. And it was just like, just shock. Like, this can't be real. Like, this has got to be some kind of like a weird prank. Like, it can't be real. This is the guy that we all listen to. This is the guy that we're all fans of. You know, I mean, at that time, everybody was listening to that kind of music, like Nirvana, Pearl Jam, Alice in Chains, like all the big Seattle bands were basically the soundtrack to my entire college campus.
I was only 9 when this happened. And you know, like, you kind of tend to gravitate toward the music that your parents raise you on. My parents didn't really have a pulse on the grunge scene at all. And so I remember hearing about Kurt Cobain passing that day, but not having any idea the actual impact that he had on this entire generation and how important he was to, you know, just Generation X. He was they called him the voice of that generation.
Oh, absolutely.
And it just did not register with me at age 9. But then, you know, you grow up a couple years, you start finding that kind of music and you realize just how significant that impact was and how devastating that loss was. You know, it was just felt all over.
And I feel like for our generation, that might have been, I know now we've unfortunately had some people we've lost due to mental health struggles and taking their own life. But I can't think of, right off the bat, like off the top of my mind, another artist at that time on that level where that was the way that we lost them. And that really wrecked a lot of us in college because a lot of us were just like, what the hell? Like, if this guy, you know, he's dealing with these things and we are too. Like, there were some scary situations where people were almost copycat situations in my college because of like, oh my gosh. Like, because it wasn't something that was, now it's talked about a lot more with mental health, but at the time it wasn't talked about at all. It was just kind of swept under the carpet.
Well, his career obviously cut very short, 3 albums during his lifetime, so it makes me curious, what is your favorite Nirvana song, Steve Migs?
That is a hard question, because I feel like every day I'm going to have a different answer. And I'm glad, because we should celebrate the music, absolutely, of Nirvana. And the first one that popped into my mind is off of their last record, In Utero. And it's the first song off of that last record, because I remember listening to it in my room and thinking, this is such a powerful song, in a sense, because he was almost addressing the success that the band had. It's, and if you don't know the song, it says, and I just love that first line where it's teenage angst has paid off well, but now I'm bored and old. And I was just like, man, he's just like, screw
smells like teen spirit. Screw whatever we did before. I'm pissed off and I'm old and I'm angry. I don't know. And he's only 26, 27 when he put this out. But I remember just hearing this and just my jaw dropped. I was like, this is a powerful song.
Oh, yeah.
What about for you?
I always liked Sliver.
Okay.
Mom and Dad
went Grandma Take Me Home.
It was so good.
And this is on the Incesticide record.
Yes.
Which is like a collection of B-sides.
Because I think they released it as a non-album single first, and then they put it onto Incesticide.
Yeah. This is a great song. Now, I'm curious with Danny and Sarah, because they're younger than you as well. And so, Danny, how old were you when Kurt passed? What, like 4?
No, like Taryn, she's only 2 years older than me, so I was 7.
Oh.
And I did not.
Maturity wise, she's a lot older than me.
100%.
I'm older than you. Have you maturity met wise, me?
Yeah, I might be the youngest in the group if we're going with maturity.
Yeah, yeah. No, I was 7, so I, and my mom was not a rock fan by any means at all whatsoever. So I did not discover Nirvana till way later, probably early 2000s.
Did you know at all the music of Nirvana, though, so your experience of knowing Nirvana was when he was already long gone?
Yeah, I was completely removed from Nirvana. I had no idea what MTV was at the time. And so for me, the first song that I ever heard from Nirvana, of course, was, and that guitar riff. Yeah. I remember sitting in guitar class my freshman year of high school because I wanted to play guitar. And one of my friends, his name was Ryan McGarvey, he knew this song, and I was like, that iconic guitar riff at the beginning is just, I wanted to learn how to play it. So that was the first lick I ever learned how to play on guitar from my friend Ryan. He's like, you've never heard of Nirvana before?
That
smells
awesome.
Like Teen Spirit. And that's it. And I went and bought the album that day.
I remember we bought that record in high school and just being like, this band is so, this is so not metal, but it's kind of metal. Like, because we were all metalheads, but it still had like that crunch of metal, but it was not, it wasn't Metallica. It wasn't that kind of a sound. So we were all just like, our jaws were dropped. We're like, this is so freaking cool.
Anarchy.
And the album cover too with the baby and the dollar bill.
Yep.
All right. So Sarah, what about you?
Well, I was 2 years old when he passed, so I was just a wee one.
So what was your favorite song when you were 2, listening to the sweet sounds?
Big fan. And then, you know, we moved here a few years later, and then I actually dated someone in middle school who was like a big rocker, so he introduced me to Nirvana.
Heart-shaped box.
I've got a new complaint. Oh, it's so good. And then I saw what Kurt looked like. And of course, I became in love. Had a big poster of him and everything. Oh, yeah. But it took me a while, you know, because I was such a wee one when he passed.
I don't know why, but I just love the fact that this was the song that got you hooked on Nirvana.
I love it.
Oh, do you remember the music video?
No.
Oh, do you remember the music video? The music video is so trippy because it's just like they enhanced all the colors to it.
Oh,
and it's
just
creepy and weird. And this was like the first single, I believe, from this record, so there's like a lot of eyes on Nirvana, like what's the big follow-up to Nevermind. And then this was it, and it's really freaking weird. Like the video, I think, probably unnerved a lot of people who were kind of anxiously waiting for this video to come out.
Also, you just see in that video how much taller Chris Novoselic was than everybody else.
Yes.
He's just like a towering giant.
Do you remember when they performed on the MTV Music Awards and Chris just threw his bass in the air? And it just landed on his head. We laugh because he's okay. But like, it just flew in the air and he didn't even catch it. It just bonked him in the head.
Today marks the 30th anniversary of the passing of Kurt Cobain, Rockaholics. So we're asking you, do you remember where you were when the news broke? Or what is your Nirvana memory? 206-803-ROCK. We'll take your calls after Nirvana. Today is the 30th anniversary of the passing of Kurt Cobain. So we want to hear from you, Rockaholics. Do you remember where you were when the news broke? Or what is your Nirvana memory? 206-803-ROCK. Brent in Port Townsend, yours is a family connection.
Absolutely. Hey, you guys are on point this morning. Great show.
Oh, thank you, Brent.
So, I was like nonchalantly talking to my mom. I said, like, yeah, this great new band, Nirvana and Kurt Cobain. And she's like, well, wait a minute. You used to play with him when you were a baby.
What?
I'm like, what are you talking about? She goes, well, you know, she's from Cosmopolis. My dad's from Aberdeen. And apparently they were friends. And she's got pictures of him being baptized in his christening. And I was like, Mom, I want those pictures. She's like, no way. I would give it to her, his parents. I would never sell him. I'm going, oh, my God.
So how old were you when you were a little kid? I mean, so how, you were a little kid. I don't know if that's a stupid question. How old was Kurt Cobain when you were a little kid?
We were like toddlers, like babies and toddlers. And then my dad got a job with NBC in Spokane and we moved. But yeah, she was like, are you, and I'm like, are you kidding me?
That's crazy.
Have you ever had any contact with Kurt's family since then?
I haven't, but my little brother was dared to go to his house on Broadmoor and ask to use the phone.
Oh.
and Kurt let him in, and my little brother said he had pink hair, and he was really super nice.
Oh, that's awesome. Thanks, Brent.
Brent, thanks for the call.
Justin in Ferndale, you got the news about Kurt Cobain's passing from Weird Al.
Yeah, so it's a kind of a weird connection there. But yeah, my buddy back in elementary school, because I'm roughly the same age as Sarah, born in 91, so when Kurt passed, I was 3. So in middle school, in elementary school, my buddy at the time showed me Weird Al Yankovic Smells Like Nirvana, because he showed me all the other stuff, like Jurassic Park, all the other fun stuff. But I loved the song, and I was like, what's Nirvana? So I looked up Nirvana. So I asked my dad, and he was like, oh, that was a grunge band from Seattle. So I looked them up and then fell in love with Nirvana from that. So my connection to Nirvana is actually finding out because of Weird Al.
I love that that's how you discovered the band, but I hate the fact that you bring them to this story, because you just make me definitely feel a lot older when you're like, Dad, tell me about this old band Nirvana.
Well, Sonny, back in the 90s.
Imagine that's how you discovered Nirvana, is through Weird Al. That's pretty funny.
Teal and Squim, you were 16 years old when you found out.
Yeah, I was 16. It was like my mother's birthday. So I was just watching TV. I don't know how she let me watch MTV at the time. And I was like, no way. I thought it was a joke at first, because I remember the whole Rome incident like a few days earlier. And I was just glued to the TV, and it was her birthday, so I had to find a VHS tape, throw it in there, and just record everything to catch what I missed on the way back. But I was just so heartbroken, because I remember when Nevermind came out when I was in junior high, and how we were going around school, and I had the shirt, and it was just a whole buzz, the whole album was. And the fact that finding out he really died, it was just beyond heartbreaking. As a 16-year-old, that was just like, it was everything. I was crushed. I just couldn't believe it. I was in shock the whole day, thinking it was a joke.
No, I feel you. I remember when we found out, I was a little bit older, but not much. And when we found out, we were all just kind of just looking at each other like, this can't be real. Like, this is just the most insane thing. A few people have been texting about their favorite Nirvana songs. And one that I definitely want to bring up, because I do love the Unplugged performance. The Unplugged performance is so great. And they said the In the Pine song, which is Where Did You Sleep Last Night? I don't know if you remember that one, but... There was a documentary. I can't remember the doc. It was a more recent one about Kurt and Courtney Love. And I remember D. Ted Smith and I went and saw it at Cinerama.
Oh, cool.
And it was like, you know, there was like a bunch of people there, friends and family of Kurt Cobain and all that. It was a big premiere of this movie. And there's a scene towards the end where he's like, they're talking about this song. And there was like some issue that he had with Courtney Love at the time. I can't remember it fully. I have to go back and watch the film. But it was... this song was almost like his reaction to something that she did wrong.
Ooh.
And when they tell this whole story, and it's real powerful, and then they cut to the part of that song, and dude, you could just like feel like this tension in the whole room. Like everyone's just like, this is heavy. It was such a heavy performance, the Unplugged performance.
And one of the most effortless performances. I mean, they just look so they just make it look so easy to sound that powerful. It's
amazing. Such a weird performance when you really look back on it. They didn't really do any hits. I mean, they did About a Girl, mm-hmm. which is a Nirvana song, but then they were doing like Meat Puppet songs, David Bowie. That song as well was a cover. They just kind of went down their own road, and I think that's what made it even more awesome. Although I would have, still to this day, I know they, I would have, as a kid, I remember being excited, thinking, oh, I'm going to hear an acoustic version of Smells Like Teen Spirit. That didn't happen.
You're going to smash the guitar afterwards.
None of that happened.
Rockaholics, we know that at some point you have had a ridiculous run-in with the law, one that you will never forget. Call us up now as we want to hear the story. And that story will give you a chance at winning tickets to see Korn. 206-803-ROCK.
The Daily Migs Show.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance, too, with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
For those in the market for flavor, there's Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, a flavorful drink that's a modern twist on a Mexican street classic with four vibrant and refreshing flavors. Pineapple, watermelon, hibiscus, and cucumber lime, made with a splash of real fruit juice. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas are perfect for any fiesta, small or big. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, boldly authentic, vibrantly flavorful. Drink responsibly. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas flavored beers imported by Crown Imports, Chicago, Illinois. Hibiscus contains juice only for color.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance, too, with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
For those in the market for flavor, there's Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, a flavorful drink that's a modern twist on a Mexican street classic with four vibrant and refreshing flavors. Pineapple, watermelon, hibiscus, and cucumber lime, made with a splash of real fruit juice. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas are perfect for any fiesta, small or big. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, boldly authentic, vibrantly flavorful. Drink responsibly. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas flavored beers imported by Crown Imports, Chicago, Illinois. Hibiscus contains juice only for color.
Now on the Daily Mix Show. Damn. Some birds aren't meant to be caged. Yet, here we are, butt naked, eating soggy bologna sandwiches. Figure it's time to get busy living and get busy winning.
Let's play Cellmates.
In the game Cellmates, lawbreakers can become game changers. And this week we are playing for tickets to see Korn at the Tacoma Dome on October 10th. Let's meet our cellmates. We have Joshua in Gig Harbor. Was there a reason you swerved while you were driving?
Yes, there was. My buddy, he usually flew to Canada, but this time This time he wanted to fly, so he parked there. I picked it up the next day. His Jeep was a crapper. And so okay. I'm swerving, and I get pulled over, and obviously I'm nervous, and he's like, yeah, you're swerving, da-da-da-da-da. He says, license, registration, you know, I'm telling him, hey, this is my buddy's car, while I'm reaching for the registration, he has my license, and he goes, oh, you're from Oregon, Mr. Fox. And I looked at him and I said, you could be a detective. And he looked back at me and I thought I was in trouble. He started busting up laughing. He said he needed that because the last guy was an a-hole.
Wow. And you were the nice guy.
It pays to be nice.
I guess.
Doesn't pay to have a crapper of a Jeep, though, I tell you.
Never, ever. Joshua, we're going to meet your cellmate, who is Mike in Tenino. Mike, when you were lighting off fireworks, I'm just curious what kind of fireworks they were.
They were firecrackers, just strings of firecrackers that we got illegally. Well, it was legal to get them from South Carolina, but not legal to bring them to North Carolina.
Yeah. And where were you lighting these off?
Behind a bank. I wouldn't suggest that.
There's really not many good places to do it, but definitely a bank would not be one of them.
So do you have any idea who called the cops on you?
No. I mean, I was pretty oblivious to the fact that we were even behind a bank. You know, we were just out cruising, looking for some good steps to skate off of, and that's just where we ended up.
Yeah. Did you guys get ticketed or anything like that, or did you just come and say, knock it off, you idiots?
No. We got put in the back of the police car, and we had to wait for a parent to come pick us up. And I was just, you know, I was freaking out about it. And I was pretty fortunate that my buddy's mom just said that she was my mom as well, and I didn't have to wait for my parents to come up. They didn't find out until, like, 20 years later, so.
Oh, okay, because I was about to say, what kind of punishment did you get? But it sounds like you got out of what a nice hookup from that mom.
That's definitely not the first time I got out of something like that.
Wow.
Just hanging out with cool moms. Well, Steve, Migs, based on the severity of the crimes of our two cellmates, who should go first in the game?
I feel like my mom would be one of those kind of moms that would also, you know, hide the information from my friend's parents.
Oh, my mom would be the opposite.
She would dime
them
out?
My mom would dime them all out.
Oh, man. Well,
she
let's
was
go,
scary.
Let's go with Mike. That's since we're, that one, that was I'm just thinking about that mom. How insane is that?
Shout out to all the cool moms. Mike, you're going to go first in the game, cellmates. Are you ready?
Yes.
Today is Mike McCready's birthday. Who is older, Mike McCready or Eddie Vedder?
Oh, I'm pretty sure Eddie Vedder is older.
And you would be correct.
You're right.
Just so you know, Eddie Vedder is 59 and Mike McCready turned 58 today.
Damn, they're almost 60.
All right, Joshua, you must get this question right for the game to continue.
They still seem like a young band to me.
Joshua, which came first, Facebook or MySpace?
MySpace.
From MySpace to my place. Do you remember that t-shirt?
Oh, yeah.
It's like, if anyone wore that, it's like, how are you even getting any action?
Mike, we're back to you. Which came first, the Mariners or the Seahawks?
Oh, that's an easy one. The Mariners.
Ow!
Wrong.
Oh, no. Joshua, if you get this question right.
The Mariners game in 77.
Mariners were 77, Seahawks were 76. Joshua, if you get this right, you're winning the tickets. If you get it wrong, the game continues. While much of the mozzarella cheese in the United States is now made from cow's milk, traditionally it is produced using the milk of which animal?
Goat?
No. That would be the buffalo. So the game continues. The game continues. We go back to Mike.
Read them chin.
Mike, which fast food chain experienced an E. coli breakout in 92 and 93 involving 73 restaurants in Washington, California, Nevada, and Idaho?
Oh, man. I am not 100% sure. It's got to be, it was Washington, Nevada, and Idaho?
Yeah.
I'm thinking local, like Jack in the Box or something like that.
It was Jack in the Box.
Nice. Wait, nice deduction. Yeah.
Joshua, you must get this right for the game to continue. Which shoe did Cinderella leave behind at the ball in the animated movie? Was it the left or the right?
The right.
Wrong.
Oh, so sorry, it was the left.
Mike, congratulations.
Yes.
Yeah.
You're going to see Korn at the Tacoma Dome on October 10th. Well done, my friend.
I did not know that buffalo were giving us any kind of cheese. Did you?
Only because of, if you guys have ever been to Serious Pie, they have buffalo mozzarella.
Oh.
You know, I would just assume that was like some kind of a nod to like buffalo wings and like a buffalo sauce. I wouldn't even made the connection that that is the cheese from a buffalo.
Oh, yeah.
Cheese from a buffalo. I'm gonna write a song about that. Beyonce is back in the news, not for her cover of Dolly Parton's Jolene this time, but for a cover of one of the greatest rock bands of all time. And the lead singer of that band has commented on her version. You're going to hear what he said after Aerosmith.
The Daily Mix Show. The Daily Mix Show.
Many people are talking about Beyonce's new country-influenced record, Cowboy Carter. And one of the specific topics is her cover of Dolly Parton's Jolene. That has been mentioned a lot. But there is another cover on the record.
You know, I just saw something, though, that said there's a lot of people that are going to be very happy about Beyonce's new record, and it's the artists that she kind of works with. Like, Dolly Parton, Willie Nelson have seen massive spikes in their record sales because of Beyonce.
Because she's Queen Bey? Queen B. What do they say?
B.
Queen B.
I thought it was Cowboy Carter.
Oh. Well, the other cover that we're talking about is Blackbird, which was originally done by the Beatles. So here's a sample of her version.
Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your life, you were only waiting for this moment to arrive.
Oh, that's fine.
But I think it's a bunch of guest vocals, well, obviously, but I think it's like a bunch of, I don't know, other popular singers that do the backup vocals on
this. Okay. I don't know why, but I was like kind of feeling it at first because it felt sincere. But then when you get all the overproduced backing vocals, it just kind of it takes away from it for me.
Too much.
I think I just realized that I have a tolerance for Beyonce of about 25 seconds. And then after that, I just got to stop listening to her. Mm-hmm. Can you please stop playing that?
Well, what do you think Sir Paul McCartney said about it?
I hope he said he hated it. I know he didn't, but I hope he did.
He loved it.
Of course he did.
Of course he did.
Well, he's about to see some massive record sale uptick, increase in his record sales because of it.
Yeah, because the Beatles record sales
are having
really
a tough time.
He said he's so happy with Beyonce's version of his song.
And I heard that he provided like actual parts from the Beatles song to be used for that, like so they could sample it, so that way it's a little bit more true to the original.
A little authentic.
Like the whatever that, what is it, the sound of the...
Oh, clapping?
Oh, I don't know what the hell that is.
Clap and a clap. That's the original tapping, clap.
The foot tapping. That's what it is.
Oh. Like, so, wait, are you trying to tell me that they couldn't have recreated foot tapping?
I don't know. I thought that was like from the original. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I misread it.
Does this sound like foot tapping from the 1960s? Am I right?
That sounds like Paul McCartney's foot. Yeah, that's Paul McCartney's foot.
Honestly, I'd
know it anywhere.
Honestly, I thought that was like a horse. Like a...
Clip, clop, clip, clop.
Yeah, that's what I thought it was the whole time.
It was Paul McCartney's horse.
Oh, gotcha.
He gave it to Beyonce so that she could record the song with that same horse.
It's an old horse.
Super old horse. It sits in a wheelchair. It's only one foot that's tapping now.
And really, the only other thing involved is the actual acoustic guitar, Steve. So maybe that was it.
Do you think he just gave all of that to her?
Like, I mean, it's Beyonce.
Here's the guitar and here's my foot tapping?
It's Beyonce.
You know, we say all that, like, as silly as that might sound, but I love sharing this story. And, you know, today, of course, being the passing of Kurt Cobain and its 30-year anniversary. And one of my favorite random Nirvana facts is Chad Channing, who used to be the drummer of Nirvana. And he was the drummer for the Bleach record. So he did not play on Nevermind. Never got to experience the success of Nevermind because, of course, Dave Grohl was the drummer. But they forgot, or maybe it was intentional, but I believe they forgot to replace the cymbal hits on Polly with Dave's playing. So originally that was recorded with Chad Channing. And he's the one who hit those cymbals on Polly for when they were doing the demos. They never bothered to re-record the cymbal hits. So that's Chad Channing playing drums on the record. So he does get a residual check from Nirvana for the sales of Nevermind because technically he played on Nevermind, even though it's legit. It's just four cymbal hits. And that's it.
It's paying the bills, though, baby.
But could you imagine how great is that? Like, I remember we interviewed him a while back and he mentioned that, too. He's like, yeah, I get a residual check from Nirvana's Nevermind. Great, it's not the same level as probably what the members got. But still, they have to compensate him because they never re-recorded four cymbal hits.
Wow.
And I'm sure Nirvana wasn't like, this sucks, we have to pay this guy, because obviously that record sold over 10 million copies. I think they're okay.
Well, considering the new Beyonce country album is one of the most popular albums of the year, so for the most popular album of the year, I'm sure Paul McCartney is fine cashing those checks. Rockaholics, a crazy and cool stat just came in about one of the final four teams in the NCAA tournament. And even though it is a fun stat, somehow this has pissed people off on social media. So we will go straight to the comments at 8:20.
The Daily Mix Show.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance, too, with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Here's why April chose to vaccinate her child.
I think actually meeting someone who was not vaccinated and now has a lifelong struggle with a childhood disease really cemented for me that it's super important that we as parents continue to vaccinate our children.
Talk to your pediatrician or visit whyvaccines.com. Brought to you by Merck.
Rockaholics, tonight, if you're looking for something fun to do, there is a fundraiser benefiting the KISW Bike MS team, and it could not be easier to participate. Basically, just show up and order a beer.
Nice.
How hard is that, right?
I mean, most people do that on Friday nights anyway.
And a dollar from every pint is going to go back and support the National MS Society through KISW's Bike MS team. So come to Crucible Brewing Company. It's right there on Everett Mall Way. And then the Bike MS Deception Pass Classic is happening in September. Where you can find more info is, of course, at KISW.com.
Everyone knows social media is a time suck, and what you're about to hear proves it. If it's online, someone, somewhere has an opinion and is whining about it. So let's get straight to the comments.
The Final Four is this weekend, and we have some busted brackets in this room.
I don't even know if I have any chance of even coming close to the top spot in our bracketology.
It's but pretty bad.
So, what is it, tomorrow, both games are going to be happening for the men's.
Absolutely. Yep. So this is the crazy story, though, of this whole situation, is that UConn men's basketball and UConn women's basketball are both in it. And they both won national championships back in 2004 and 2014. So 10 years later, we're going to find out if they're going to win it again.
What if that happens? That is so trippy. Every 10 years, they both win it together?
I kind of hope it happens now, just to be able to say.
But it would suck, though, if it does happen, because what about the pressure for the teams in, what is it, 2034? If all of a sudden they make it and everyone's looking at them like, dude, you can't F this up. Right now, we've got 3 decades of this happening.
So UConn women's basketball team plays tonight. The men's play tomorrow. Many are excited about this, but of course there are some miserable people on social media.
No.
So let's go straight to the comments.
So we came across a few social media posts about this video, about this stat, and we sent them to our production director, Jason, a.k.a. Veggie Dog, a.k.a. VD. And we said, pick which one's your favorites and reenact them however you want. And he did just that. All he's doing is basically illustrating just how angry and ridiculous people will get on social media, sometimes over the most trivial stuff, including a fun fact about the fact that UConn's won it every 10 years. So here's our first comment as we go straight to the comments.
I am calling shenanigans if they do. Every decade for 3 decades? That's a little too fishy.
I love a good conspiracy theorist.
I'm here for it.
But do you really think that?
No.
All right, let's check out our next comment.
Yay, Final Four. I can't wait for this to be over. All of you was getting excited to watch entitled college kids play a sport. I hope all your brackets are bust. The world's falling apart. We need to prioritize and maybe, I don't know, save humanity. Sports are brainwashing you into thinking everything is okay. I hope all the teams lose.
Let's invite that person to our party on 420 at Chuck E. Cheese. They sound like a blast to hang out with.
I'm starting to feel like we hang out with the conspiracy theorists before that guy.
I'd rather watch the UConn men's and women's teams make out for 2 hours than watch 1 minute of the Final Four.
Okay. All right, you're into basketball thumbnails. That's fine.
You know how 6 degrees to Kevin Bacon?
Yes.
I feel like we're going to, with social media, it's like 6 degrees to the pervy comment. Like, this has nothing that sounds, that you could create any kind of weird adult content from. And, of course, that guy did figure it out. So, thank you. Thank you, commenter, for that.
All y'all, these comments are f***ing insufferable. Have you accomplished anything in your adult life because you're making it painfully obvious that you're all peaked in high school? Y'all need to go to loser therapy. Stat!
Now, that person sounded angry, but I kind of agree with them. Everyone's getting all pissed off at college athletes. It's like, what the hell did you accomplish by the time you were in college?
Absolutely nothing. Why is this showing up on my timeline? Big deal. I just took a massive dump. Want to report that on ESPN?
I like that he's wondering why it showed up on his feed, but also had the time to make a comment.
Well, what else are you going to do? It's social media.
Yeah.
He's probably on the toilet while he's doing this, and he's just upset and jealous that nobody's reporting on that.
That's true.
And he's right. I think ESPN needs a good... No, never mind. We'll just leave it at that. Again, a harmless post about a harmless stat when it comes to UConn, and somehow, some way, people find reasons to be mad about it.
I know who's happy about it, though. Our number one UConn fan, Sarah.
Yep, got them going all the way, and I believe I still have Purdue.
Yep.
What?
No, you don't.
Yep. Yes, I do.
Danny, do we dare ask Danny to even try and do the math?
I'm winning. That's all we need to know.
She is winning.
She's going to win it all.
She's probably going to win it all. I think it's between her and Tatum. Unless...
Tatum?
Yeah.
My 4-year-old daughter?
Look, she had Tennessee going the whole way, right? Is Tennessee still in it?
No.
Oh, never mind. She's not in it
anymore.
I'm
the last one standing, y'all.
We are so screwed with Danny doing this.
At least one of us knows what's up.
Well, I mean...
Did George help you with these?
No, I did a little research.
Sure she did.
Did you just look at the colors of the jerseys and pick your favorites?
Well, maybe we should have done that, too, because I don't think either one of us are doing very well at all. I know you're not.
You had terrible.
You had Wazoo and Gonzaga going to the finals.
Yep.
Who did you have in yours?
I had North Carolina.
And Kentucky.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, that Kentucky game.
I should have thought about NC State, not North Carolina.
Yep. Yeah, you didn't have UConn. You didn't have Purdue going that far. You had UConn all the way to the Final Four.
Okay, so I got that.
Yeah, but then you had them lose to North Carolina.
Well, you know, sometimes stuff happens.
Ups, downs.
All right.
Well, today, Rockaholics marks the 30th anniversary of Kurt Cobain's passing, and one Seattle radio personality had the emotional task of being the first to report about it on the air. We're going to chat with Marty Reamer about this moment after the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
The Daily Migs Show! Hey! The Daily Migs Show.
Rockaholics, today is the 30th anniversary of Kurt Cobain's passing. And we've talked about it a couple times on the show this morning. Everything from where we were at the time that we learned the news to what our favorite Nirvana songs are.
And for many rockaholics, the way that they found out the news was through our next guest when he was working at KXRX, a radio station that was around during those times. And it's our friend Marty Reamer. Marty, thanks for joining us.
Hey, guys. Nice to be on the air in Seattle.
That's right. You're over in Germany, huh?
Yep, coming to you live from Berlin.
Technology. This is so amazing.
Yeah, it is amazing. Yes, I was working at KXRX at the time, a radio station that, if I remember my radio history correctly, KISW crushed.
Fair.
No, unfair. If you don't mind my, if you're on the other side of that coin,
Can we go back to that time? Because I mean, that's something that's come up quite a bit in the Seattle days. Whenever we talk about, like, when's the first time you heard about it? I remember over the years, people would say, "Oh, I was listening to Marty Reamer, and he,
you had the unfortunate task to go on the air and share the news that you found out before anybody else did. Could you take us back to that time of how you found out? What was the feeling like when you shared that news and just your overall connection to the music of Nirvana?
Yeah, well, just a little bit of backstory. So, yeah, we were working at KXRX, but KXRX had already it had already been announced to the staff that we were changing format and that it was going to be a country station and everyone was going to be let go. So that was the mood in the building at that time.
Wow.
And so no one took radio very seriously because we knew we were all short timers. And in fact, that's why I was on the air. I was filling in for Robin and Maynard, who had already taken leave of the station. They'd left the building. And I was doing news at the time. And our producer, a guy named Larry Firo, came in and said, there's a guy on the line. He says he has the story of the century for you. And I said, okay. And we punched up and it was this guy who said, oh my God, I have got quite a story for you. I work for an electrical contractor and one of our guys is out on location at the home of Kurt Cobain and he's lying there next to a shotgun. He's committed suicide. I'm not sure he got through the entire story the first time because we thought, okay, kook on line one,
right,
gone, hung up on him. The guy calls back a minute later and says, now, don't hang up on me. This is true. And he goes into a little bit more detail, says, you know, the electrician was walking by, he's installing an alarm system, was walking by a window and saw the body laying there. And I'm thinking, still, you're nuts. If this were true, we would certainly not be the first ones hearing it.
Right.
And so I didn't believe it. So we shut him down again. And then he called the front desk at the radio station. And I thought, man, if this guy is a nut, then he is really committed to his story. And our producer thought, well, you know what I should do? I have a friend at the Seattle Police Department. I'll call. And he called the Seattle PD and said, is there anything going on perchance at the home of Kurt Cobain? And they said, we've sent a cruiser to his house. That's all we can say. And as soon as we heard that part was legit, we felt like likely because of the detail that the guy had provided that the rest of the story was also true. Although having said that, I mean, because back to your original question, we still didn't believe it. We thought it's not going to be Cobain. It's going to be some fan who was trying to show his allegiance to Cobain and decided to do something crazy and shot himself in Cobain's house. And I mean, there were many scenarios that we could dream up, many of them also horrible, but that didn't involve Cobain having committed suicide. But we went on the air with it saying, we have a report, tentative at best, that Seattle PD has been dispatched to the home of Kurt Cobain. And there is a suspicion that there is a suicide victim and it may well be Kurt Cobain.
Wow.
And when we said that, yeah, you have to kind of put yourself in our shoes. We weren't taking radio very seriously at the time. We thought, well, we're going to be unemployed in a week. You know, what's the matter? So we didn't believe it, but we thought, yeah, we'll just share what we know so far. And then the phones went nuts. I mean, it went nuts, not like a typical radio station, you know, where people from Seattle were calling. We were getting calls from South America and from Europe and the Associated Press was calling and then horrible, like it was Kurt's sister or his mom, one or the other, called up. And then we were like, oh Lord, we do not want to be the ones to have told his family that he's passed on. So anyhow, that's the story.
And obviously that was, you know, the biggest story of that
of our
that
generation.
Time.
Yeah.
And, you know, obviously that day was very chaotic for you. But how long did the chaos continue beyond that first day?
Oh, beyond the first day? All I know is that I was stunned at how much the chaos continued that day. I mean, the chaos that day was insane. Insane. We were off the air then, just, you know, I think 45 minutes after we got the call, we were off the air. And then we drove down to Cobain's house and stood there. I don't know if either, were either of you in Seattle at the time?
I was, but I was only 9.
I was in New York. I was a college kid, and I remember having to talk about it on the college radio station. But granted, that's an audience of like 17 people, an entire city that is, of course, very endeared to Kurt Cobain that you're having to break this news to.
Well, and like I said, at that point, it was not just the entire city, and this is what stunned us. It was the entire world suddenly, and we weren't ready for that either. So we went down to the home to try to legitimize this, to try to see, was this really what was going on? And it was anyone who's been to that house before, have you guys ever driven by the place?
A couple times.
I haven't.
Yeah, I mean, it was a gray, drizzly, I mean, kind of a typical spring day in Seattle, but really gray and dark. And the house, you know, you kind of look up this curved driveway at the house and you could see a little bit around the corner. And then you go to that park next door where at that time you could look right down onto the garden house where he actually committed suicide. It just seemed like a haunted scene and creepy. And that's what was most vivid in my memory, is they're looking at that scene around the house at the time.
Obviously, today is the 30th anniversary of Kurt Cobain's passing, so naturally we would want to speak with you about this on this specific day. But how often do you find yourself talking about this, you know, year in and year out? Because it still is one of the biggest moments in music that people remember and connect to.
Yeah, well, first off, one clarification. This is the 30th anniversary of his death, but remember, they had to back time it. They had to figure out when did he actually die, mm-hmm. because it wasn't, my involvement didn't come into play until April 8th. Mm-hmm. So it was April 8th, 1994,
right,
that I got the phone call. So that anniversary is yet to come. So if you really do put yourself back 30 years on this day, people were still frantically, or his family and friends were still frantically looking for him. He had gone missing after fleeing the drug treatment center down in L.A., and nobody knew where he was.
And we're talking about Marty Reimer. And Marty, to go back to her in that time, I mean, obviously I'm a massive Nirvana fan, and I'm sure you were very much a fan of them as well. Do you have, because we were taking some great stories from our listeners, sharing some fun memories. For someone like yourself who was very knee-deep into the Seattle music scene and a part of all that craziness that was happening here in Seattle at that time, what is a favorite Nirvana or Kurt Cobain memory that you have?
I never met him. He scared me. A little bit, because, you know, they had they and you know, a lot of the people of the grunge music scene had kind of a tenuous relationship with commercial radio, because they were anti-commercial, they were anti-establishment, and we represented more the establishment by being on commercial radio. I have to say, he kind of scared me. Chris Novoselic was always the affable one.
Yeah.
And of course,
Dave Grohl.
Dave Grohl. God, I can't believe I fried on his name. They were the ones, the front facing members of Nirvana that we met on a regular basis and loved those guys.
Marty Reimer, thank you so much for joining us this morning to talk about that experience. You're the only person that can tell that story, and I'm so glad that you told it to us this morning.
And I didn't know that you guys knew that your station was changing formats just days later. That is a heavy few days for you to have to kind of like stomach it, on top of like, oh, what am I doing with my own future? And then now this insane amount of news has just dropped in my lap.
Yeah. It was a crazy time for us and for Seattle, and it turns out, for the world. My pleasure to be on with you guys. Carry on the torch. Remember, you put us you put the radio station in the ground.
Well, thank you for the
thanks,
love.
Marty.
Awesome, Marty. You are a legend. We appreciate you so much.
My pleasure. Take care, you guys.
Take care, Marty.
Rockaholics, how would you like to beat Steve? His record is 84 wins, 23 losses, and 12 ties. Oh, my gosh, in 2024. 206-803-ROCK. We will play Beat Migs at 850.
The Daily Migs Show.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance, too, with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
For those in the market for flavor, there's Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, a flavorful drink that's a modern twist on a Mexican street classic with four vibrant and refreshing flavors. Pineapple, watermelon, hibiscus, and cucumber lime, made with a splash of real fruit juice. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas are perfect for any fiesta, small or big. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, boldly authentic, vibrantly flavorful. Drink responsibly. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas flavored beers imported by Crown Imports, Chicago, Illinois. Hibiscus contains juice only for color.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
For those in the market for flavor, there's Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, a flavorful drink that's a modern twist on a Mexican street classic with four vibrant and refreshing flavors. Pineapple, watermelon, hibiscus, and cucumber lime, made with a splash of real fruit juice. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas are perfect for any fiesta, small or big. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, boldly authentic, vibrantly flavorful. Drink responsibly. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas flavored beers imported by Crown Imports, Chicago, Illinois. Hibiscus contains juice only for color.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Hey, Whatcom County. The holidays are over and lots of Americans are financially drained. Luckily, Bayside Coin and Jewelry pays top dollar for scrap gold, jewelry, and gold, silver, or platinum coins. If you have a pile of old jewelry or a stash of silver dollars, bring them into the store and see what they're worth. Or visit PacificRimCoins.com/calculator to get an instant quote using our free scrap calculator. That's PacificRimCoins.com/calculator for an instant quote.
The Daily Migs Show presents the most popular radio game on this side of the speaker. Let's play Beat Migs.
I sure am, because we made it. It's Friday.
It's Friday, Friday.
Oh, man.
Losing my pants.
You are.
Wait a second.
She's jumping so hard, they're falling down.
Do you, not, do you have a belt?
No.
No.
Do you wear a belt every day?
Yes.
I feel like belts are like dude things.
I agree.
But do women not wear belts?
I do sometimes if it's part of like a coordinated outfit.
Yeah.
Well, how about just to keep your pants up if you're going to jump up and down?
Maybe I should start wearing a belt on Fridays.
The suspenders.
Oh,
yeah, tie in suspenders would be a good look.
Do not tempt her.
I want this to happen.
I want it to happen, too.
I'm surprised you don't have any, to be honest.
That's a good call.
Well, she will after this weekend.
She will. Let's get to Jeff from Puyallup. Jeff, are you there?
I'm here. I'm wearing a belt, and Taryn in suspenders is a cool band name.
Oh, yes!
That sounds like a funky ska type band.
They're going to rock.
Yeah.
I'm Sarah, your host, and it's time for you to get out of here, Steve.
Bye-bye.
For those playing at home, Jeff has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you'll only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Yes.
If you score a hat trick, how many goals would you have scored?
3.
Correct. Be all you can be is the slogan for what branch
Army.
Of the military? Yes. What team is tied with UConn for the most NCAA championships?
Uh-oh. Oh, Mississippi. I don't know. Pass.
Michael Jackson teamed up with what guitar player for his song Beat It?
Eddie Van Halen.
Yes. What U.S. state is directly above Texas?
Oklahoma.
Yes. What actor co-stars alongside Sean William Scott in the comedy Role Models?
Paul Rudd.
Yes. How many planets in our solar system have rings?
2.
No.
1.
No.
3.
No. What redheaded singer has the hit songs Perfect and Shape of You?
Oh, Ed Sheeran.
Yes. Which of the 6 main characters on the TV show Friends never got married?
Which one? Joey.
Correct. O'Hare Airport serves what American city?
New York.
No.
O'Hare. Chicago.
Yes. What team is tied with UConn for the most NCAA championships?
Carolina.
No. Jeff? You got 8 correct, Woo! Though.
All right. Woo! That's the best I've done for a while.
Okay. Well, and I feel like that's the best any listener has done in a while, to be
that's
honest.
That's very true.
Well, there was Taryn back on Monday.
Oh, yeah. Taryn killed it.
Actually, you know, you're right.
That was a fine performance.
Taryn was a genius. The last time I think Steve got beat was by Taryn on Monday.
Okay, there's an asterisk to that one.
If you haven't listened, go listen. It's remarkable.
She was working. She was working those suspenders.
She was. Steve, are you ready?
Yes!
If you score a hat trick, how many goals would you have scored?
3.
Correct. Be all you can be is the slogan for what? For the
Army.
Whoa, yes. What team is tied with UConn for the most NCAA championships?
I'm not Kentucky.
No.
How about North Carolina?
No.
I don't know. I'm going to just make up a team. I'm going to go with Purdue.
No. Michael Jackson teamed up with what guitar player for his song Beat It?
Eddie Van Halen.
Correct.
Nice.
What U.S. state is directly above Texas?
I'm going to go Alabama.
No.
I don't know. Dallas.
No.
Oh, wait, that's not.
Oh, my.
I'm still
Arkansas?
Counting. No. What actor co-stars alongside Sean William Scott in the comedy Role Models?
Oh, crap. Paul Rudd?
Correct. How many planets in our solar system have rings?
I'm going to go 2.
No.
3.
No.
1.
No.
Damn it.
What redheaded singer has the hit songs Perfect and Shape of You?
Annie.
No.
Ed Sheeran.
Correct. Steve, you got 5 correct.
Wow.
Which is a big loss. 8-5. Let's go, Jeff. Suck it, Steve.
Jeff, he's our man. If he can't do it, nobody can.
Literally.
Steve can't.
I wish you had those suspenders so I could muzzle you right now.
Oh, my gosh. I'm so excited. Okay, what team is tied with UConn for the most NCAA championships?
I'm just going to throw out Duke, but I don't know.
No?
The New Mexico Lobos.
Absolutely
okay,
not.
Let's not get crazy.
UCLA.
UCLA, baby.
Oh, nice.
Okay.
They both have 11.
Oh, all right.
But this
that
year,
could change this weekend.
It's sure going to change. It is. And how many planets in our solar system have rings? You both said 2, 3, and 1, and it's 4.
I should have
kept going up. I had 2 and 3.
And then you just said 1.
Like an idiot.
Also, can we talk about your knowledge of U.S. geography?
Mm.
Or lack thereof?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, I don't know if this will come as a surprise to you, Taryn. I never did well at geography growing up as a kid.
Oh,
because the U.S. state directly above Texas is not Dallas.
Oh. Oklahoma, where the wind comes sweeping down the plains.
Oh, no.
Not everything has to be a song title.
And the waving wheat will sure smell sweet.
No one has heard that song ever.
Everyone has heard that song.
I've heard the song.
What?
Yeah. I'm not okay with hearing it again.
Is it just about Oklahoma?
It's a show tune, baby.
I think you're a walking musical.
It's from Oklahoma, isn't it? Yeah, that makes sense that they have a whole song. I was like, what's a Washington song then?
Oh, yeah, look at that.
Is this it right here?
Oh, no.
They couldn't take a better time to start in life.
I like how Steve said he didn't want to hear it again, and then he pulls up the song to play it.
Sometimes my curiosity trumps my intelligence. Is this it?
She doesn't even know.
Maybe I haven't heard. There it is.
The wind comes sweeping down the plain, and the waving wheat will
come on.
She's doing the dance, too. I don't know if you noticed, Steve.
I do love the fact that she had no idea what the song was during the verses. So you just know the hook.
I regret asking this question. But it is Oklahoma.
Yes. Rockaholics, is there an appropriate time and place to bother a celebrity? Or is any time a good time to say hi? A well-known celebrity just shared that she was once hit up for an autograph while on the toilet. You're going to hear what happened after Joan Jett.
The Daily Migs Show.
Steve Migs, during your absolute favorite television program, The Kelly Clarkson Show.
You guys always try and call me when it's on. I'm like, shut up, Kelly's on. Yeah. I'll call you guys back.
So during,
I don't even know what time Kelly Clarkson's show airs.
I think it might be like 11 o'clock.
I've watched zero episodes of it, but I do love that she does like a musical performance.
Yeah, she's got pipes.
It's hurting me to even say nice things about the show. She covers like other artists' music, and I think it's really cool to hear her versions of it.
Oh, yes. So on the Kelly Clarkson show recently, an audience member asked her about strange interactions that she has had over the years with fans. And here is Kelly talking about it.
Mine was using the restroom.
What is it, Winnie?
What's the strangest fan interaction you've ever had? I've had someone literally come in like while I'm in the stall and just slide paper and pen under. And I'm fine. Look, I'm just going to be real. I wasn't just peeing.
I do love her honesty. All right. So if you're Kelly Clarkson or Taryn Daly, you're the biggest star in the world, or you're a massive celebrity and you're in a bathroom and someone slides a piece of paper underneath the stall and asks you to sign it.
I would wipe with it and hand it back.
Oh, my God.
Okay. I would just sign it and try and end this awkward exchange as quickly as possible.
I would wipe, hand it to them, and say, put that in a shadow box and hang it on your wall.
No, you... Okay. Oh, my God. I'm not even asking any further questions. Let me ask you, Sarah. What would you do?
I would absolutely sign it.
Right?
Yeah, and then probably wouldn't want to meet them when I'm done.
Oh, so you're going down the, hey, kiss every baby kind of mode.
Yes. I think that's an awesome way to just...
I think if that happened to me, and it never will, I hope. But if it ever happened to me, I would just be like, this is awkward. And then I would sign it and hand it back. I would let them know what they're doing is very weird. But I also want it to end as quickly as possible. And the quickest way to have it end is by signing and just giving it back to them.
Well, and in defense of the fan who chose this method for getting the autograph, once the celebrity has left the bathroom, it's a free-for-all. That's where all the other fans are going to be asking for autographs, possibly. So that bathroom might be the best opportunity.
I do remember, it's funny because WrestleMania is this weekend. I remember I was in Dallas and there was a wrestling event after WrestleMania. All these independent wrestling shows will put on like shows around that time to try and like get some of the large influx of people that are showing up to whatever town it is to maybe come to their small independent show. And we went to a show, myself and Kevin Deers. We went to a show at midnight after WrestleMania because we're losers. And we went to like some VFW hall in Dallas, Texas. And Jake the Snake Roberts was there. And, you know, luckily we've met him already, so I didn't bother him. But there was a moment I was at the urinal, and who stands right next to me also sharing the same urinal. Not the same one, but, you know, it's like one of those long urinals. It's not like separate urinals. Not like we had just partnered up. And it's Jake the Snake Roberts. And I already had a couple drinks in me.
Oh, no.
And it took everything in my power, and I didn't. But I was like, man, there's a snake, Jake the Snake Roberts joke that I could throw in right now.
But it won't go well.
Sword fight.
No, I was like, oh, now I know why they call you the snake, Jake. No. I was like, you know what? Just going to shut up, look the other way, and not even say a word to
you
him.
You said nothing.
What am I going to say? He's taking a number one right next to me. Sup, dude?
Are you just trying not to even stare then at that point?
Well, usually
at his face.
Taryn, I don't know if you understand how urinals work, but you never really stare at the person next to you. You just kind of stare at the wall.
But if the person's a big celebrity.
Wait, you didn't even just casually take a glance?
Well, I knew it was him.
No, I mean like.
She's wondering if you.
Oh, like meat gaze?
Yeah. Yes. Did you say?
No.
What did you say?
Meat gaze. Yeah, you gaze at their meat.
I didn't know that was a term until
right
now.
Why did you get so excited about that, Taryn?
I didn't know my hobby had a name.
I'm shocked you didn't. There wasn't just a little bit of curiosity.
Not an ounce of curiosity.
What?
I don't ever spend my days wondering what the size of a unit is of a celebrity.
But if it's right next to you.
I'm fine with not knowing. There's never been an instance where I'm like, I wonder what he's packing.
Okay, the moment Drake leaked that video, I was on Google trying to find it. Like, the moment it's out, there's a curiosity for me.
Do you think it's because you're attracted to guys and like maybe like that there's a curiosity just to see what they're packing, just like you could kind of assess?
No, if females did the same thing and had a urinal and stuff and there was a celebrity next to me, I would take a peek for show.
Okay. Well, it'd be very weird if you guys had a urinal because you'd have to sit the other way and the whole thing.
We'd have to
Danny, would you
it.
Look?
No, of course not.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, they just don't understand what urinals are like.
We don't know urinal etiquette, apparently.
The only time we do anything besides just pee is when Steve and Castle go in and take a selfie together.
Yeah, but that's just for social media.
Well, yeah.
For the fans.
Yeah.
For the fans.
I don't know what fans. No, definitely not only fans.
The only fans.
More like lonely fans.
Well, speaking of fans, Rockaholics, we know that you are a massive music fan, but could you name a song after only hearing 1 second of a chorus? Prove it. And if you do, you could win tickets to see Iron Maiden. 206-803-ROCK. We will play Hook or Shook at 9:20.
The Daily Mix Show.
For those in the market for flavor, there's Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas, a flavorful drink that's a modern twist on a Mexican street classic with four vibrant and refreshing flavors. Pineapple, watermelon, hibiscus, and cucumber lime. Made with a splash of real fruit juice. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas are perfect for any fiesta, small or big. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas. Boldly authentic, vibrantly flavorful. Drink responsibly. Modelo Spiked Aguas Frescas flavored beers imported by Crown Imports, Chicago, Illinois. Hibiscus contains juice only for color.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance, too, with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
The Daily Mix Show presents the Extreme Music Showdown. Let's play Hook or Shook. Please sign this waiver before we continue. Thank you. We'll drop a 1 second snippet of the hook of a song. If you can't name the song, watch out. You're gonna get shook.
It is time to play Hook or Shook, and this week we are playing for tickets to see Iron Maiden at the Tacoma Dome on October 16th. This morning, our contestant is Darren in Bellevue. Good morning, Darren.
Good morning.
So you must get both songs right to win. The first one, you will be on your own. The second one, and this is where you can get shook, a member of our show at random must get it right for you. If not, you will lose, and caller 9 will get those tickets. So let's see who you're playing with. Will it be me, Migs, or Sarah?
It's on Taryn, now it's on Sarah. It looks like it's going to be on me, and yep.
That's Migs, baby.
All right, Darren, it's you and me, baby.
All right.
Let's win you these tickets.
Great, thanks.
All right, Darren.
All right, let's do it.
Here is your clip.
Oh.
I got it.
Oh, my. Can I hear it one more time, please?
I can help you if you need help.
I do need help. Yes, please.
All right. Let's start with the artist, and maybe that'll help you get down the right road. Think red baseball cap backwards.
So, Limp Bizkit?
Yes.
And I'm thinking it's Nookie.
Oh,
no.
No. Break stuff.
Sorry, Darren.
Darren, I'm so sorry, right, my man. It's not the first, won't be the last time Limp Bizkit has let somebody down.
It's just one of those days. Oh, I could listen to that whole thing.
Why can't we just play the whole damn song? Limp Bizkit all day long.
206-803-ROCK, caller number 9. We'll get the tickets to see Iron Maiden at the Tacoma Dome on October 16th. Also, just a tough act to follow. Hooker Shook today versus yesterday with Quinn.
I bet Quinn would have got it right. I'm kidding. Although I think he probably would have. Yeah. That kid crushed it.
I used to have a nickname back in the day that was the human jukebox, and mm-hmm. I think I'm going to pass that torch to Quinn.
I do love after we had Quinn, who's 12 years old, and he nailed Tool Schism without even needing a hint or anything. And somebody texts and goes, Quinn is the GOAT.
He is.
Yes.
Rockaholics, if we talked about something this morning that you would like to talk about, give us a call now, 206-803-ROCK. We're going to check in with the Rockaholics after Metallica.
The Daily Migs Show.
Rockaholics, all morning long, we have received texts and phone calls from you that we have not yet had a chance to chat about. But now is the time. We're talking to you. We're checking in with the Rockaholics. So anything that's on your mind, give us a shout. 206-803-ROCK.
A few texts have been coming in about the earthquake in New York. People are like, hey, did you guys hear there was an earthquake in New York? I don't think I've ever remembered a time that there was an earthquake in New York or New Jersey. I'm sure there must have been at some point, but it's very rare.
They don't have the same plate tectonics there that we do here.
I do love, though, you go on social media and you click on, like, earthquake in New York, and, like, just to see what kind of stuff's going on, get a vibe of what's going on the East Coast, and it seems like everyone on the East Coast is already cracking jokes. You know, like, the usual meme, whenever, like, a windstorm happens, we're supposed to be scared of, and it's not nearly as bad as what you thought it was going to be. A lot of people are posting pictures of, like, their lawn furniture knocked over and saying, together we will rebuild.
So it wasn't too wild.
Nothing that I've noticed. It was a 4-something magnitude earthquake, and it sounds like they got hit with another one just again. But for the most part, it just sounds like it just kind of like, I mean, literally shook people up a little bit. But nothing massive, at least that I've seen so far.
Still very freaky, of
course. Yeah, still scary.
206-803-ROCK. We are checking in with the Rockaholics. Today is the 30th anniversary of Kurt Cobain's passing, and Seth in Puyallup wants to talk about getting yelled at in that moment.
Yeah. Hey, what's up, guys?
What's up, Seth?
Thanks for having me on. I got yelled at, actually, by back in 2000, one of the competing stations over there at the end. I called up because, look, I love Nirvana, but they were playing Nirvana like twice an hour. I didn't have a tape player in my car, so I had to listen to the radio, and they were kind of killing the vibe for me with, like, so much. So I called up, and I said, hey, I love Nirvana as much as the next guy, but maybe a little less so I can enjoy it more. Without skipping a beat, I don't know who it was, he goes, hey, buddy, this is Seattle Radio. Why don't you go F yourself? And then hung up on me.
Whoa.
Seth, that was me. I'm sorry. I was a bad day. No, I'm kidding. I wasn't here when...
You know what? I respect the response. I absolutely respect it. And I love Nirvana to this day.
Nice. Thanks, feel you. Seth.
That's a great story, Seth. Thanks. That would be awesome if it was me.
Oh, my God.
Full circle.
We are going to talk to an interstate hauler in Seattle, obsessed with wrestling as a kid. We were talking about things we loved as teens.
Hell yeah.
And you and Steve Migs are both wrestling fans.
What's going on, Migs?
What up, dude?
Hey, I'll tell you what, brother. The wrestling, pro wrestling, I remember when it was Portland wrestling.
Yes.
I can still tell you all the old school wrestlers. They're finishing maneuvers. I have followed wrestling, I mean, from day one. I made when it came to Seattle. That was a blast. We got WrestleMania coming up. Dude, it, you know what? It might be entertainment, but I'll tell you what, buddy. It's good entertainment, and I'm all over.
Your phone's cutting out on a lot, but man, thanks for the call, Interstate Hauler. That's awesome. Yeah, dude, I was the same way. I obviously still am. It's just something about nostalgia, too, and especially when I watch, like, the older wrestling stuff. And Portland, like you mentioned, Portland was a hotbed for wrestling back in the day, like the Jimmy Snukas, the Roddy Pipers, all like the classic guys that eventually became massive WWF stars, all spent some good time. Even Ric Flair and Sting, all those guys at some point spent some time in the Portland territory.
Nice. Scotty's on I-5 and wants to get some advice from us.
Okay.
Scotty, you think you're getting catfished?
Yeah. I think it's a kind of obvious. It's the way this, I have to say person, is texting me isn't quite like normal English, like how you would text someone.
Okay.
But, so it was kind of silly at first, but today at work, she sent me a picture and, not of her naked or anything, but definitely, post-workout gym clothes, cute.
How did you
I'm
first?
Like, oh, this is...
How
Sorry,
did,
go on.
How did you first start talking to the person?
Random number not saved in my phone. It was just like, "Hey, how's it going?"
Oh, and come I said, on, no, Scotty, you didn't fall for that.
Oh no, not at all. So I said, "Who is this?" And she said, "It's Amy." And I was like, "Who do you think this is?" And she said, since then, I deleted the conversation thinking nothing would come of it. But then she texted me a couple days later. But she's like, oh, is this Miss Lucy or something?
Yeah.
And so
Scott,
I've been...
You might want to block that number and just not respond anymore. Like, it's not going to go well if you keep having a conversation with that person. I thought he was pranking us at first.
I thought so, too.
Don't you? We all are getting those. I'm getting those way more now. I feel like at least 4 or 5 times a week, I'm getting someone saying, hi, how are you? Yeah. Or, hey, long time since we've talked. Or, miss you. And I'm just like... Delete and block, delete and block, delete and block.
I've been in his position before, though, where I respond back, but not because I believe it. I just want to F with them.
Yes.
So I'm just sitting there being like, hey, and then I turn the scam back on them. I'm like, yo, I really need $100 or I'm going to jail. So you need it. Can you Venmo me? And they usually get very angry.
Who the hell do you think you are? I'm the one that's supposed to be scamming. Yeah, Scotty, stay away from those calls.
Yeah, if you ever think you're getting catfished, we're the ones that can help.
And Scotty, you probably should never click on any links.
Rockaholics, how is it possible that a popular ice cream cake, one that is available at many grocery stores around here, could sit out of a freezer for days and not melt? We'll tell you about this at 9:50.
The Daily Migs Show. The Daily Migs Show.
There is a woman named Hope who went on TikTok to share a video that showed her dilemma involving an ice cream cake. Do you know this company? Is it Carvel?
Or? Oh, don't even get me started.
Is that a real thing?
It's the greatest place ever.
Where is it?
Based out of Atlanta, but most of their places are in New York.
So is this like a thing you grew up with this company or?
Yes.
You look really
You've never
intense.
Heard him go on his.
Oh, I'll tell you more after you get
yes.
to the, yeah.
So the Carvel,
get to the lady, but I've got some information for sure.
The Carvel ice cream cake in question remained unmelted even after it had been thrown away in the trash for a day. So here is Hope talking about it.
This was a Carvel ice cream cake that I bought for my child for her first birthday. It was so good. I ate it, except I put it in the garbage 24 hours ago and it didn't melt. So I think this isn't ice cream. And I'm about to lose my mind. I'm debating eating this just to taste it. Oh my God, what is that? No, I can't do it. I'm so sorry. This isn't ice cream.
So in New York, we were obsessed with Carvel. We follow each other on Instagram, like me and Carvel. We're big friends, you know.
You should be a Carvel influencer.
I've been trying to figure out a way to get Carvel to come out here. Their soft serve is next level great. They have a cake called Cookie Puss.
Cookie what?
Cookie Puss.
Okay.
They also have Fudgy McWhale. And then around St. Patrick's Day, it's Cookie O'Puss.
Oh, my God.
Oh, you've never had Cookie Puss? Oh, Cookie Puss is the best. Oh, my
what
gosh.
What is happening?
Yeah, so this whole story is just kind of crazy because, you know, you could go to, like, Fred Meyer, Safeway. They sell Carvel frozen ice cream cakes in their frozen food section.
Here?
Yes, 100% here.
This is my first time ever hearing about
this. And it's so freaking good. I did not know, though, if you leave it out. I kind of want to get one. We should get one and see how many days we could leave it out without it melting.
Isn't that a thing with Willy Wonka? Like, they have, like, a never-melting ice cream?
No, that was, like, the never-ending sucker. Like, the never-end...
They have that, too, yeah. But
stopper.
I want to say there was a whole thing about, like, the never-melting ice cream, too. So that's... Maybe they're just in with Wonka.
It just makes you wonder, though, what is this ice cream? Is it ice cream, or is it just, like, a cream-based cake that tastes, when cold, tastes like ice cream.
So before this story came out, did you feel like you knew this information?
No, I had no idea about this. I can't believe you don't know Cookie Puss.
No.
So here's a crazy story. So remember when I was doing those Migs Fest parties, like we were doing at Studio 7? And on the podcast, when we used to do the Migs cast, I would always talk about how much I love Cookie Puss, the ice cream. It's so delicious. It's so freaking great. I used to get it for my birthday all the time. So some listener spent good money to have a Cookie Puss cake shipped out here. Had we known, we didn't even need to keep it cold. But they had it, like, they contacted Carvel and they had it mailed out here and surprised me with it at the party, which was amazing. I'm like, this is so great. So we put it on the party bus and we're like, well, we'll get to it later after the party's all done. We'll sit on the bus and we'll eat some celebratory cake. Someone got on the bus and stole the Cookie Puss.
Oh. You are joking.
I was never more devastated in my entire life.
That person, I hope bad things happen to them in this life.
I can't believe that you don't remember like the great commercials.
Here's some ice cream cakes that only Carvel makes. They're made fresh every day, 'cause that's the Carvel way. And while you're at the store, say Cookie Puss and more. And don't forget about Hug Me the Bear.
The friendliest bear.
They had also Fudgy the Whale.
Hug Me the Bear. He looks terrified.
Dude, some of the commercials were weird, like they were in space. Hey, I'm Cookie Puss.
Really,
this is a total New York thing. I understand that.
So, Sarah, being that you grew up kind of on the East Coast, yeah, when did you move out here? How old were you?
I was 8.
So do you know these? Do you know this cake?
Not at all.
Okay.
No. I wasn't a Cookie Puss lover.
The only reason we know this is because of Steve Migs, yeah.
Oh.
Okay, here we go again.
Carvel selects your present from outer space. My real name is Cookie Puss, but my friends call me CP. I'm a Carvel ice cream cake, and I make fresh daily every day.
And the best part is they just use the same, like, structure, like the mold to make Cookie Puss the cake, and then they would, like, turn it, and then it was a whale. Like, it was just, they just repurposed the same mold, but then they just put different toppings to make it look like a different cake.
I had no idea.
The Beastie Boys wrote a song, Cookie Puss.
Really?
Yeah, one of their first songs back when they were like this weird like punk hip-hop, but more punk band. They had a song called Cookie Puss. Oh
my gosh. I didn't know this was one of your passions, Steve.
I love Cookie Puss.
I
want nothing more than a Carvel to be here. I would go back to eating dairy for Cookie Puss.
Wow.
Yeah.
Let's note that today was the day that Steve Migs said that. So you're a Cookie Puss fanatic. I know you're also a WrestleMania fanatic. It's happening this weekend in Philadelphia, and The Rock has already found a way to piss off all the people of Philly. What did he say? You're going to hear it during the Daily Migs download after Rush.
The Daily Migs Show. Knowledge is power. So give us five-ish minutes, and we'll give you some interesting stuff you can talk about at work. This is the Daily Migs download.
A.K.A. the DMD.
Here's your daily dose of doings happening in the world.
Ryan Castle is here with us this morning. Ryan, do you remember where you were when you learned the news that Kurt Cobain had passed away 30 years ago?
I was thinking about this the other day, oddly enough. I was babysitting for one of my mom's friends, and I heard it come on the radio, and they played a bunch of Nirvana and stuff that night on the radio,
I'm very concerned that someone let you watch a child.
I was like 15 at the time,
someone
I guess.
Someone put you in charge of a child?
Yeah. Several of them. You guys make parenting like so hard. All you have to do is you put them in you put them in the bathroom. You close the door. You leave the toilet seat up in case they get thirsty. That's fine.
Oh my god!
Parenting tips from Ryan Castle.
Yeah, he wouldn't even do that to his dogs, but to a child, sure, why not? Let's go.
My dogs deserve nothing but the best.
They deserve better than toilet water. Hey, the DMD is brought to you by Palace Law. And I don't know if you noticed, but our friend Taryn Daly over here, she's celebrating Bell Bottoms Day. Did not even realize it, but she's wearing Bell Bottoms on Bell Bottoms Day.
It was just a strange coincidence.
Okay.
So next time, maybe you shouldn't wear those joggers. You should be putting on Bell Bottoms.
My joggers are tight at the bottom. It's the opposite of Bell Bottoms.
You're like anti-Bell Bottoms.
I'm completely blowing it. I had no idea, and you can tell I'm crushed.
Well, this weekend, it's WrestleMania weekend, baby. The showcase of the immortals. It's happening in Philadelphia. The big story, of course, is that The Rock, Dwayne The Rock Johnson, back in the ring for the first time in forever. He's going to be teaming up with Roman Reigns. They're going against Cody Rhodes and Seth Rollins on the opening night, which is tomorrow for WrestleMania 40. But I bring all this up because they're doing a bunch of events in Philadelphia where the wrestlers are showing up doing Q&As with fans. People pay money to just go see them.
And throw batteries at them because it's in Philly.
It's in Philly. So worst decision ever, if you're The Rock, you decide to show up not one, but 2 hours late to the event that people paid to see you talk
at. That's not cool.
So the moment he walks out, I mean, there was other wrestlers there as well. It was a big event, but still, 2 hours late, he gets out on the stage, everybody starts booing him, and then he found a really great, in quotes, great way to endear himself to the fans of Philadelphia.
Are you booing because 2 hours The Rock was supposed to be here at 4 o'clock? Is that why you're booing? You're booing because The Rock was a little late. Is that why you were booing? Why was The Rock late, you want to know? Are you sure? You want to know? Why The Rock was late? He was watching YouTube, watching Jalen Hurts lose in the playoffs again.
Now keep in mind, this is not Dwayne Johnson.
This is The Rock.
This is The Rock.
That's right, the final boss. Right.
I love it so much. Steve Migs, you and I were massive fans of the TV show Money Heist.
Yes.
I wonder if these people were also fans of this show, because an elaborate heist happened in Los Angeles on Easter Sunday, and it may be the biggest in the city's history. They say around $30 million in cash was stolen from a money storage facility in the San Fernando Valley area.
Wow.
The thieves apparently entered through the building's roof and accessed the vault without setting off any alarms. So now they're saying that there could be some inside help. So the LAPD is still investigating what exactly happened, but it could be an inside job.
And apparently the company, because we had a couple people text in, and there's some like local ties to the company. They're like, it's just bananas what's going on behind the scenes right now because of this heist.
That's what I call my house, the money storage facility.
Well, this weekend, some people are going to be losing some money because it's the finals. It's over after this weekend, right? Is it over?
This is Final Four
Final
this weekend.
Final Four,
and
right.
Is it Monday?
That's right, yes. Well, NCAA Men's Tournament, we're at the Final Four. We've got Connecticut, we got Purdue, Alabama, and NC State in the Final Four. Of course, our friend Sarah over here is rooting for UConn.
Let's go!
University of Kentucky. We're joking, but that's what she thought they were. And they're taking on Alabama, number 4. I think the rest of us are probably rooting for NC State, the number 11 Cinderella story, taking on Purdue this weekend.
The grand opening of the new Linwood Link extension, the light rail, is opening on Friday, August 30th, which is great news for the Snohomish County folk like myself.
Oh, yeah.
Sound Transit is saying that there are going to be like 47,000 to 55,000 daily riders by 2026. So hopefully this could make a little bit of a, you know, dent in the traffic concerns of those of us that live up north.
Yeah, we've been working on it since the movie Singles back in the day.
Remember Steve?
It's finally happening.
Steve was trying to get that on
the
rail.
Tom Skerritt wouldn't let it happen. See, Tom Skerritt, you were wrong.
Damn straight. Pearl Jam tried to make it happen, and now it's finally happening. Hey, as far as weather, we're going to hit a high of 53 and cloudy. I love that you related to the movie Singles.
Yeah.
I love that. That's the DMD, and that's what's up.
Ryan Castle is up next with the Morning 12 Pack.
The Daily Migs Show.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
At Metro, get an iPhone 12 with 5G and a dual camera system for $99.99. Take amazing pictures and share them instantly. And don't put up with life's yada yada.
Yada yada.
Like photo bombers. Zoom, crop out,
yada yada,
and bye.
You don't take yada yada in life, don't take yada yada from your wireless provider. Get iPhone 12 with 5G with no activation fees and nada yada yada. Only at Metro by T-Mobile. Switch to Metro, bring your ID. This offer isn't available for customers currently at T-Mobile or that have been with Metro in the past 180 days.
At some point, we all need a new car. Why wouldn't you choose a dealership that promises a great value and peace of mind? At Kia of Puyallup, Great value begins with an easy and friendly buying experience. Then Kia of Puyallup adds even more value by including oil changes for life as long as you own the car. Peace of mind comes from knowing that your new Kia is protected with the Kia of Puyallup Lifetime Powertrain Warranty. Test drive a new 2024 Kia Sportage or Telluride today. Kia of Puyallup, since 1995.